Hello everybody. Today we are going to do chapter 15, Safety Habits. We must always take care of ourselves and others. Accidents usually occur due to our carelessness. To avoid accidents, we should always be careful and alert. We should follow safety rules all the time. So, this chapter speaks about the safety rules. Safety rules ensures our safety. We should be very careful and alert all the time in order to avoid accidents, because accidents give us wound and pain. So we should be very careful if we want to avoid accidents. Safety rules. While going to school, we see buses, scooters and cars moving on the road. We are safe only when we follow the traffic rules. So safety rules are to be followed on road. So while going to school, we see buses, scooters and car on the road, and we should follow the safety rules in order to avoid accidents. Safety while walking. We should always walk on the footpath. Where there is no footpath, we must walk on the left side of the road. So in order to be safe on the road, we should always walk on the footpath. And in cases where there are no footpaths, we should walk on the left side of the road. Safety while crossing the road. We must cross the road at zebra crossing. We must cross the road only when the traffic light is green. So children, this is zebra crossing, and we should always cross the road at the zebra crossing and not from anywhere in the middle of the road. And also when the traffic light is green for the pedestrians. Pedestrians are the people who walk on the road. Number two, when there is no zebra crossing, we should wait until the road is clear. We must look to our right, then to our left, and finally to the right again. When no vehicle is coming, we should cross the road. Okay, children, there are places where there is no zebra crossing. What should we do then? We should cross the road when the road is clear. When there is very little traffic or no traffic, we should look to our right, then to our left, again to our right, to make it quite sure that there are no vehicles coming up. Then we should cross the road. We must not run across the road. Running across the road is not advisable. It's not permissible. So we should not run across the road in order to cross it. We should be very careful on the road. Safety while traveling in a bus. We should be careful not only on the road, but we need to be careful while traveling inside a bus also. So let's see. Number one, we must stand in a queue at the bus stop while waiting for the bus. So we should stand in a queue, in a line at a bus stop, in order to get into the bus. And we should not try to push other people just to get into the bus before everybody. Number two, we must not lean out or put our hand out of the window of a moving bus. So not putting our hands out or not leaning on the window is very much necessary while traveling in a bus, because if we put our hands out or put our head out of the bus, we must be hit hard by the other coming vehicles on the road. So we should stand in a queue. We should not lean out of the moving bus, and do not get in or get out of the moving bus. Number three, we must not get in or get out of a moving bus. We should first allow the bus to stop completely before getting out of it. Number four, we must not keep standing on the footboard of the bus. We should not keep on standing on the footboard of the bus. Once we board the bus, we should go and sit in a definite place. Number five, we must not disturb the bus driver. So we should not disturb the bus driver when he is driving the bus. Then he would be disturbed. Accidents might occur. We must be quiet in the bus. We must sit quietly in the bus and not make noise, because doing that would disturb the driver and he might end up in driving the bus in a wrong way. So while moving on the road, you see the following traffic signs. Name them using the words given in the box. Number one is one way. Number two is no U-turn. Number three is no pedestrian. Number four is no parking. Number five is no horn. Number six is no entry. Number seven is railway crossing. And number eight is zebra crossing. Okay, now let's come down to safety at school. Safety should be maintained not only on road or in a bus, but in the school as well. How can we be safe at school? Let's see. Number one, we should not jump on the benches. Number two, we should not push anybody even in fun. Number three, we should not play rough games. So we should not be jumping on the benches. Benches are meant to be sat upon and not jumping on it, because you might just trip and fall. We should not push anybody, whether we are in the classroom or in the park or in the playing area. We should not play rough games. While playing games, we should be gentle and we should not play rough games by hitting others or even pushing others. Now, what are the various rules of safety at home? There are so many safety rules that needs to be followed at home as well. Let's see, what are those? We should not play with sharp objects like knives, blades and scissors. They can cut our skin. So we should not play with blades as this girl is doing in the picture, or with the knives or scissors as this other girl is doing in the picture, because we might end up cutting our skin and bleeding. Now, number two, we must not touch electric wires, electric plugs, hot irons and electric heaters. They can give us electric shock. So we should not be touching electrical appliances, whether they are electric wires, electric plugs, hot irons or electric heaters. They can give us electric shocks. We should not leave our toys on the floor. We may fall over them. We are not supposed to leave the toys on the floor because we might just trip and fall over them. Others might also fall over the toys and get hurt. Now, number four, we must not run down the stairs. We may fall down. We are not supposed to run down the stairs because we might just fall down. So we are not supposed to touch hot iron or other electrical appliances. We are not supposed to leave toys on the floor, or we are not supposed to run down the staircase. We need to follow these safety rules at home in order to be safe. First aid. What is first aid? Let's see. When you get hurt, tell an elderly person at once. Your teachers at school or parents at home will give you first aid. So whenever you get hurt, make it quite sure that if you are at school, you tell your teachers, and if you are at home, you tell your parents. They will use the first aid box and heal your wound and help you. Instead of doing anything wrong with your wound, you should tell your elders. Always follow safety rules to keep injuries and pains away. So we should follow the safety rules in order to keep ourselves safe, because if we are not safe, we might injure ourselves, which might be very painful. So many rules are needs to be followed on road, at home, in school, at park. Those rules are very simple, but they go a long way in helping us to stay safe. Okay, children, so this is the end of the chapter. Now let's do the exercise. Tick the correct answer. We must cross the road only when the pedestrian traffic light is yellow, red or green. Yes, the traffic light pedestrian traffic light should be green? So the answer is number C, green. While traveling in a bus, we must keep quiet, moving or shouting. Yes, while traveling in a bus, we must be quiet. The answer is number A. We should not play rough games. We should not play dash games. Fair, rough, indoor. We should not play rough games. Number 4. We should not touch hot iron cups. Number C, balls. We should not touch hot iron. The answer is number A. Number 5. You see your friends playing on the road. You know how dangerous it is. What will you do? Keep quiet and go home. Number B, join them in their game. Number C, tell them it is dangerous. Yes, you will tell them that it is dangerous. The answer is number C. Now let's do fill in the blanks. We must cross the road at the, number 1 would be zebra crossing. Yes. Number 2, we must not keep standing on the footboard of the bus. Number 3, while traveling on the road, we must walk on the left side of the road. Now, number C, tick the activities we must do and cross the ones we should not. Let's see. In picture number 1, the boy is disturbing the driver, which should not be done. So we would put a cross mark. Number 2, the children are standing in a queue while boarding the bus. So number 2 is correct. Number 3, the boy is jumping on the benches in the classroom, which is wrong. He might just trip and fall. So number 3 is wrong. Number 4, the girl is running down the staircase, which is very dangerous. So number 4 is also wrong. Answer the following questions. How can we avoid accidents? We can avoid accidents by following safety rules. How should we cross a road if there is no zebra crossing? If there is no zebra crossing, we must look to our right, then to our left, and finally to our right again. When no vehicle is coming, we should cross the road. If you see on page number 55, the answer is in the point number 2, safety while crossing the road, second line. We must look to our right, then to our left, and finally to our right again. When no vehicle is coming, we should cross the road. Which two things should we not do at home for our safety? So, for our safety, we should not play with sharp objects like blades, knives and scissors. And we should not touch electric wires, electric plugs, hot irons and electric heaters. So children, we come to the end of this chapter. See you in the next chapter. Please like and subscribe our channel if you like it, and we would bring more videos.